Let it be known that Cassius Della Penna saw himself in the mirror for the first time tonight. Eric has a 3-month-old baby. And then there he is. Papa Della Penna, come stai stasera? Sente bene? Sì. Bravo.
Thank you.
We've been together on tour for nearly a year now. Or over a year, actually. Has it been over a year? Well, ironically, we did a benefit for the Center for Constitutional Rights. That was one of our very first shows. It was actually our first show in New York for the tour, and now one of our last shows is benefit again for the center. And I'm happy that they're here tonight.
Thank you.
The man who lived in a plywood box under a tunnel on 72nd Street. Did you read that article? 13 years. He lived in a very tidy box that he had made himself. And there was an impressionist, well, a poster of an impressionist painting in his little box, and a little cook stove, a little bed, a little cupboard, and a little air shaft not far away. Did you read that article? It gets more sad. And I'm not going to talk about it right now. Because we're about to do a very sad song. And the sad chatter and sad song equal Natalie singing off pitch because she's crying. So here we go. Gabriel.
Oh,
passes every one.
Thank you.
upsetting. Oh, cute. Oh.
Hi. Hi, ladies.
There's a place for me somewhere. A place for us. A place for Beaky. And a place for.
Wait, the other way.
Place for Whisper. For Beak, place for you, place we like to speak of somewhere.
I'm embarrassed to admit it, but
a while back, we were touring in England. Every time I go to England, that's the weather, I guess, I get sick. But I came back, I was really, really sick. I was trapped in New York. Oops, sorry. And I went to the doctor, and the nurse was so sweet. I was, And the nurse was so sweet. She went out to get my prescription. And she, got me a little beanie baby, too. Now this one would have a voice. It's really pathetic. I'm not one of those women, grown women who keeps stuffed animals from way back. But I just, beanie babies have those eyes. They just melt you when you have 104 fever for the fourth day in a row. It's still delirious. It was me and my beanie. It's a little penguin. So I'll save these for next winter when I need. Baby. And now I'm a convert. I should know to leave them home.
say. I took the first and the last letters into the news. This lottery's been building up for weeks. I could be lucky me with the 5 million prize days of disrelease filling out my eyes.
Dry your eyes. They told your life.
You should be grateful. I tell your life is short. Be thankful, because before you know, it will be over.
Thank you.
this time.
Record.
Old Fairport Convention, you hear me? Old. I was in the elevator in my building today, and these two little girls, about 11 years old, one of them goes, "You know that old show, Mark and Mindy, you know? That guy Robin Williams, before he got famous, he was in, he was a superhero." And she goes, "Oh." And I went, "Old." "Is that an old show?" I searched. "Is that considered old?" Well, I think, wasn't it the 80s? I can't remember the 80s, what happened to them? And now the 90s are almost over. But, I'm stalling.
Verdi Kreis!
Verdi Kreis. You know what I can tell you about Verdi Kreis?
Yeah.
I haven't played it since September, and that's really shaky ground. I don't intend to tread upon. And I'm doing it for your sake. I'm not doing it for your sake. We're probably going to do a song that's the diametrically opposed to Verdi Kreis. Difficult to believe the same human being could conceive both, but it's true. We're going to do Jealousy.
Thank you.
Okay, I remember this one, so I'll do this one. Thank you.
an organization. One moment. It's a benefit for an organization I've been supporting since I had disposable income. Which was basically when I could start sending them $100. And 1984, I think, I started sending money to this organization. And the executive director, Ron Daniels, is here from the Center for Constitutional Rights, a very important organization in the United States, doing incredible work domestically and internationally, and they're based here. Ron Daniels, come on here. Tell us what you do.
Everybody, we just want to say thank you so much to Natalie. And let me just say, it's very difficult these days because we can ask, where have all the beautiful people gone? Because the world is sometimes very mean and very tough. But because of people like Natalie, we know that we have hope going into the future. The Center for Constitutional Rights is a public interest legal institution, and we believe passionately in the Constitution of the United States and the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And most recently, though it was not popular, when the bombs started to fall on Kosovo, our attorneys were in court saying that we ought to go to negotiations, not confrontation, that it was not appropriate to be bombing in Yugoslavia. And in the distant fields of Burma, where working poor and working people, particularly women, are often paid quasi-slave wages by corporations that are headquartered here in the United States, we are in court saying that that is not fair, that is not right, that is not just. And in the city of New York, where Rudolph Giuliani is our mayor, when he attempted to close Elmhurst Hospital and Coney Island hospitals which serve average working people and poor people in the public sector, he wanted to privatize them. We went to court, we defeated him on the lower level, then we went to the higher court, and we won again. And finally, we believe that we have to have safe communities. We want our communities to be free of crime, but the police ought to be servants of the people. And we don't need situations like Amadou Diallo and Abdi Louima. And so the Center for Constitutional Rights is filing a lawsuit against the Street Crimes Unit saying you cannot go out and just stop and frisk and harass our people. And that work is possible because of beautiful, courageous artists and entertainers and people like Natalie Merchant, who could just be, you know, like make money. But because she is the person she is, she supports the Center for Constitutional Rights, and we love her for that. So Natalie, thank you so much.
And I'm sure there's literature available in the lobby on your way out if you'd like to see the docket. It's pretty impressive, the work that this organization has been doing for years and years and years and years. And here come my people. It's the best band I've ever been in. Eric, Gabe, Elizabeth, Susan, Peter, Graham, Dave, Doug, my band. It's my band until when? Monday morning. Don't say that before we start the song, right? We'll meet again, don't know where. Don't know when.
Yeah.
thoughts could bring the cold.